Hello. I'm going to take you through this little lecture for COP4813, which is about registering a domain name. This is one of the important skills that you need to have as a web developer or website programmer. If you don't have a place to put these domains or this stuff that you're developing for your clients, well, you're kind of only halfway there. So first, as part of the web programming series of courses, and right now the web programming series of courses, Web Systems 1, Web Systems 2, Database 1, and Database 2, you do need to register a public domain name for this. And this domain is going to be used in multiple courses. So there are some requirements that if you're going to use it for just COP4813, it's simply a capability of hosting pages. But when you move on to COP4834, you have to have the ability to do scripting and database backends, which you also need for COP4709 and other programming, other series courses that you have. So some of the requirements that you have right now, you need to be able to host a database, you need to be able to host multiple pages. As we move on through other courses, you're going to have the ability to host multiple scripting languages. So what kind of domain hosts can do this? Well, I'm using right here as an example GoDaddy. For the most part, most of you have probably heard of GoDaddy. They have lots of commercials. They advertise very heavily. And it is a full-service web hosting company. They register the domains. They will host the pages. They have all the different products for being able to manage. You can put your own servers and operate them in their server resources. So it's got quite a bit of capability and services. And they've also got they're very well known because they do have good customer service. They get back to you very rapidly. So it's the most used American domain name, domain registrar that there is. So it's a good one to talk about. But it's also not the only one. If you are going to select a domain host, then one of the things that you need, things you'll need to do is actually be able to look at reviews of what they can do and what kind of customer service and expectations can you expect from them. So using something like a consumer search or best consumer reports is important, because you choose the wrong domain and you're working with a client that needs to host this domain and you're the one responsible, doesn't look very good. So when you're going to be doing this hosting, the first thing you need to know is what type of needs are you going to have for this hosting. Customers tend to always overestimate what their level of page needs are going to be, but still, regardless, you need to be able to manage the throughput and the number of pages and host the number of pages that the client needs are going to actually have. So if they're expecting 1 million page hits a day, that's a pretty heavy load that you're going to have on a server, especially if they have very special needs, such as the ability to host video, pictures, and other types of things which are bandwidth intensive. The other thing that you've got to look at is what kind of databases are they going to need. Are they going to be using SQL Server, Oracle, MySQL, Postgre? Web pages today are simply not just static pages that are served up off of a web server. You usually have to have the capability of integrating in your own databases and other databases into those pages. Also, what kind of scripting languages are you going to need to be able to support, like .NET, PHP being two very common ones, but there can be all sorts of different types of server-side scripting that needs to be supported to meet those client needs. Then you have a whole host of other services that you may need to have. You may need to have a marketplace and inboxes, mail services, which are very common things that you need, shopping carts. All those are things that you need to find out from the client whether you're going to need them, and then make sure that you've got the capability of hosting those things. Now, to do this, I typically rely not on going to the domain host to see if they've got that capability, because they always seem to tell you that they've got all the services that you need. Well, I use external reviews, find out what other people have said about the services that are there, and also the things that you need to know about are the costs associated with it, because most services have one level of service that they have at one cost level, but then they have higher level services that they offer at premium levels of costs, and that cost differential can be significant when you need to move to that higher level. Also, know how responsive the customer service is, because when a website goes down for a company, it's a big deal for that company, and you may need to work with customer service to get that site back up. So having a 24/7 customer service that's very responsive is important. And the big thing is get an independent review of how well do these hosting environments do the job that they need to do. So the steps for, you will need to know how to do is, one, register a domain name. And that does always cost, because there's a cost associated with registering domain names. But typically anywhere between $1 and $30, which is a fairly high range considering, go from 1 to 30. But, that's just the way things work. You can register a .info or a .name domain name at GoDaddy for, I think, roughly $2. And you've got a domain name registered. For the assignments for this class, register a domain name that you can reuse. If you don't have your own personal home domain for yourself, register that domain and use it for this class. You could also register a domain that's specific to the classes that you're doing, but you may want to use these things later on, and now that you've got them set up and hosting, might as well stick with it. Once you've got that, you need hosting and domain name registration are different things. You need to have a hosting account and make sure that your domain points at the hosting that you have. Most registrar hosts are going to have the ability to easily point the domains at the hosting account, just as kind of by default. Having the ability to upload pages, meaning that you need to have some easy type of FTP access to do that, and any other needed services that you need to have for this, how easy are they to use and can you get to them? Do they have the services? And how much do those services cost? Those all become important. So you've got the requirements for what you need to do for this class. And these assignments, everything that you do for, say, 48013 and other courses, typically you're going to post those live at a host, and they're going to be available via your domain. So these are real assignments that you've really got to do. So have fun with this. You're getting started now, and this is where things are going to live.